Area 5 has a lot of heritage with a lot of common hardware that is shared with the Area 1. The engine is the same engine, but will have to be qualified, as I'll show you a little later, to do something that it doesn't have to do on the Area 1. We'll have to do some further qualification testing. It will probably carry over a lot of the avionics, whether or not we will locate them on a ring or distribute them on the various areas where we have not yet decided. This vehicle is really in the early formulation stage. So what I'm showing you is a representative vehicle, but we're in the phase A. There's a lot of things. I can pretty well assure you when it's built, it won't look like that. There will be some changes because of that's the nature of the design process. You learn from that. We also are using a derivative of the RS-68 engine that is flying today on the Delta IV. We're using six of those on the core stage. This is an opportunity to take advantage of something that exists. We'll have to do some mods, and I'll describe those. But you can see that there is a lot of commonality between the two. We will have on this one, our current plan is to have a 5.5 segment. We believe that there's enough robustness that we'll be able to use the same chutes, but if we have to, we'll design new chutes. That's not yet a given, but we think we've got enough robustness with the new chutes for the 5 segment. We can use those for the 5.5, but that again is one of the challenges. This is how the vehicle stacks up. It's a very large vehicle. It's 381 feet tall. That will be the largest, tallest vehicle ever built. We have above the platform, the launch platform, we have a clearance of 390 feet at the VAB. This is going to be 381 feet. So it's got just a little bit of margin, but not much. We're constrained by the height of that. That orange part on the bottom is the core stage. We'll talk about that more, but I just want to make the point here, as you can see, where the forward attach point of the solids is, that is between the hydrogen tank and the LOX tank, the same slick design that was used on the space shuttle to carry the load. So all the loads forward of that are all carried down. The inertial loads are carried down through the solids, and the core stage hydrogen tank will carry the thrust loads of the 6 engine. It's the same kind of a very complex load path, but a very efficient one. That we used on the shuttle. The solid rocket boosters, 5.5 stage, will be recovered. We expect that to be contracted out. We expect to contract out the core stage. NASA will probably do the vehicle integration in-house, as we were doing with the Ares 1. You can see the payload fairing above and the Altair payload, which will be briefed on this afternoon, show where it fits in there. And, of course, the Earth departure stage with the J2X is going to be a challenge in its own right. This is what the profile looks like, and we'll do something similar to what we do on the shuttle, in that we'll light off all six of the RS-68 engines on the pad. If they all come up to nominal thrust, then at that point we will give the command to light off the two solids. Once at that point, just as is true in the shuttle today, you are committed. There's no way to shut the solids down, so you don't light them off till you're sure you've got six good engines. If you do, then you light them off, and they burn in parallel. And this vehicle is going to weigh a little over 8 million pounds. The Saturn weighed a little over 6 million pounds. So this is going to be not only the biggest, it's going to be the heaviest that ever flew. And it's going to have about 11 million pounds of thrust. It will have good thrust to weight. It'll be about 1.37 to 1 thrust to weight. Its dynamic pressure will not be quite as high because of the fact we've got more weight on it. Even though we've got more thrust, we've got more weight relatively. So it doesn't accelerate quite as fast. It'll have a little higher Q than the shuttle, but it will not be as high as the Ares 1 does. After the solids burn out, they are jettisoned into the ocean, just a little ways downrange, about 130 miles or so downrange. They'll be recovered and reused. Then we'll continue with the core stage burn. When it has burned out, it will then be jettisoned. and it will be dumped into the ocean. It will go into the Atlantic Ocean off the coast of Africa. And then we will fire the Earth Departure Stage, and it will burn just over half of its propellant. And it carries about 600,000, roughly 600,000 pounds of propellant. It will burn a little over half of that, getting into orbit, and it will shut down. Then we will bring the crew to it that will be launched separately on Aries 1. They'll get together in Earth orbit, and after some 4 days, up to 4 days of loiter, it will then be fired a second time to do the translunar injection.